Welcome everyone to the VC Circle classroom. I am Aliff Fazelbhoy from ALMT Legal, and I am here to tell you a little bit about initial shareholding, creating a shareholding structure in a company, and a little bit about primary and secondary shares. So to get started, as you all know, a company is an artificial person. It's created under law by natural or individual persons. The company is effectively born when the registrar of companies issues the certificate of incorporation. You have seen this in previous lectures. Prior to the birth of the company, the creators, who are known as the promoters of the company, have undertaken certain obligations. And one of the obligations they undertake is to subscribe or to take a certain number of shares and put in a certain amount of money into the company. So when the company is born, the first obligation, just like when a natural baby is born, the first obligation of the parents is to give it food. The first obligation of the promoters is to give the company some money so that the company can start business. It can take property, it can hire people, and do what it has been incorporated to do. Let us assume there are two promoters. The minimum capital in a private company is 1 lakh rupees. And the two promoters, in the memorandum of association, when they undertake to set up the company, they also undertake to subscribe to the minimum amount of capital needed. They could subscribe to this 1 lakh equally, 50,000 each, or they could do it in a different proportion, maybe 90,000 and 10,000, or even 99,999 and 1 rupee. It's entirely up to them. Once the company is born, the certificate of incorporation is issued, these promoters need to give this 1 lakh of rupees to the company. That is the initial capital, and in return for this, the company issues shares. Shares are nothing but a right of ownership in the company. So say they are two people and they've agreed to put in 60,000 and 40,000 respectively. So one would get 600 shares of 100 rupees each or whatever, and the other would get 400 shares. So there'll be a total of 1,000 shares. This would represent 1 lakh of rupees. These are the initial shares, and it represents the ownership of 60% and 40%. So the money goes now. The company is not a person. It cannot put cash into its pocket. So the company will have opened a bank account. This will be opened in the name of the company by the initial promoters and directors. The first promoters also automatically become the first directors of the company. This is the initial capital and the initial shareholding. Now the initial shareholding of course will change, because a company cannot live forever on 1 lakh of rupees. So the company then needs, as and when it needs more money, the company will issue more shares. It could be to the same two people, or it could be to other people. A private company can have no more than 50 owners or shareholders, and a public company can have as many as they want. There's no limit. So let's say after a week or 2 weeks or a month, the company needs more money, and it will tell the people, I need more money. So these two people will say, okay, now we'll put in some more money and we'll take some more shares. And if there are some other people who want to also become owners of the company, they can also put in money, subject to, the company agreeing to allow them to become owners or shareholders. One of the main formalities is to file what is known as a return of allotment, and this has to be filed with the registrar of companies. And so you file a return of allotment which says, I have issued 500 shares to Mr. X, and now my capital structure is three shareholders and each holding so many shares, and next time you issue shares, the same thing happens. The only exception is for the first shareholders, the promoters who have agreed to take up shares in the memorandum. You don't need to make a filing, because that memorandum is already with the registrar, and he already knows that these two people are going to, put in so much capital and take shares. I will now quickly for a minute discuss primary and secondary shares, because these terms are often, you know, referred to loosely without really knowing what actually they mean. Now, strangely enough, in the Indian Companies Act, there is no concept of primary and secondary shares. You have the concept of equity and preference shares, and equity shares is, you know, the normal shares you take, which is called as risk capital, and preference shares are those which have certain preferential rights, but in return they don't have, you know, an upside. It's kind of a risk-free capital with a fixed return, but with less amount of voting rights and less of the upside. The other popular meaning of primary and secondary shares is primary shares are those which a company itself will give to the people who put in capital in the company. So I put in 500 rupees in the company's bank account, I get 50 shares. Secondary shares are, you know, when an existing shareholder will sell his shares to someone else, because I may no longer want to own the company, or I may own 100 shares and I may want to sell 50 and in cash some profits. So I'll come to you and say, hey, I've got 100 shares, will you buy them from me? And you say, yes, I'll buy them from me. And you give me whatever price we agree. Or if you buy it on the stock market, then as per the stock market rate. So when you buy those shares from me, the money comes from you to me, it doesn't go into the company. And that is known as a secondary sale. So it's not a primary sale or primary issue from the company to you, but a sale from me to you of my shares. And that is known as secondary sale. And they popularly refer to, you know, these shares as secondary shares. It's not a legal term, it's a popular term. So that's primary and secondary shares. I hope that's given all of you a fair idea of how the shareholding of a company works. Thank you.